Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom is the sequel to Jurassic World, and I'm not gonna give this movie much of an intro at all. I'm just gonna just dive straight into what I think about this film. All I'm gonna say right out of the gate is that it's not atrocious, okay? I don't think it's good at all, not even close to being good, but it's not atrocious. I have seen other critics, other YouTube reviewers, you know, say that this is just complete garbage, really no value in this at all. You know, I can sympathize with that point of view, that's for sure, but I don't think it's atrocious. I've seen atrocious.
You hear that, B? You gonna talk, buddy?
And this is not that, but this is certainly not a good movie, and this is not a movie that I would honestly recommend to anybody, only if they just care about action and they only care about watching dinosaurs just wreak havoc and tear shit apart. If that's really all you want from this movie, you'll like it. But if you need more, like if you want substance or character arcs or an unpredictable storyline or really every other aspect of filmmaking that makes a film good, you will most likely not like this movie very much. But before I move on, I'm gonna warn you, I will be getting into some spoilers. Like, this isn't like a spoiler talk video where I'm just gonna just talk about everything that happened in the movie. But as I'm reviewing the movie, I have to spoil some things because I have to get some of the things that really got under my skin off my chest. So just to start, I think the direction of this movie is flat or just non-existent. There really isn't much of a touch to this. Like, there's nothing really clever about the way that everything went about in this film. Everything from the cinematography, you know, uninspiring, the sound design, uninspiring. Some of the dinosaur noises that are used in this movie, I swear, were the same exact audio clips from the very first Jurassic Park. It's like they recycled that audio. Like, for instance, like the T-Rex, it sounded almost identical to the audio that was in Jurassic Park. The aesthetic quality of this movie is just, you know, it's whatever. It's your basic Hollywood movie, and I think that's where my first main just upsetting, disappointing point comes in, which is the fact that this is just really just your average Hollywood action movie. And, you know, normally, like, you know, you already know me. Everybody who watches this channel and has followed me knows that I don't like Hollywood movies either way. But what really just irks me is that this comes from Jurassic Park. Everything that made the Jurassic Park movie great, the very first one, everything that just made that movie stand out and really was just praised among critics, everything that critics praised and everything that people loved about that film is not present in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. It's just not. And I'm sure there's some people out there that's gonna say, well, it's not Jurassic Park, it's Jurassic World. You know, they're trying to rebrand it. They don't want you to linger on the previous films. Well, I just call BS on that because there's tons of attempts to like reach at the nostalgia of Jurassic Park in this movie. Tons of them. And it still like rides off the back of those movies. If it's gonna attempt the nostalgia in the movie, if it's gonna try to get me with those little nods and those little Easter eggs, you know, I'm sorry, I'm gonna judge it on the standard of Jurassic Park. They asked for it. And I don't wanna spend too much time just comparing this to the first Jurassic Park, so I'll kinda just try to fly by this fairly quickly. When I said that everything that I thought made Jurassic Park special is not in this movie, what I mean by that is in terms of character, and especially theme. But really, what I really enjoyed about it was that it's really thought-provoking, on top of it being really thrilling, scary, and entertaining, and just also just having that spectacle element to it. It's also just, like I said, extremely thought-provoking, and Jurassic World completely lacks that, both one and two. Just to go ahead and just get to a specific point about something about this movie that I just really, just bugged me just to my core from the very beginning. So the initial conflict in this movie that's established is that, oh, all the dinosaurs that were left behind in the previous Jurassic World movie are now stuck on that island. And on top of that, there's a giant volcano that's gonna erupt and just naturally just kill off all the dinosaurs that are on that island. And when I first heard that, I'm like, okay, that sounds nice. What's the problem with that? And then even on top of that, Jeff Goldblum's character, you know, he's just like,
that life finds a way.
And in my head, I'm like, yeah, I mean, isn't that what we learned in pretty much every Jurassic Park movie, especially the first one, that we should not have done this, and we'd push the boundaries of science, and we shouldn't just do something just because we can, and we should kind of take a step back and think about whether or not we should do something, regardless if we have the capabilities to do it. You know, that's pretty much the main theme of the movie. But our main characters, played by Chris Pratt and Bryce Dallas Howard, they're, you know, eventually both of them want to go and save these dinosaurs off the island and put them in a sanctuary somewhere so they can all live. And I'm just thinking, why did they choose to do this? Because you basically want us as the audience to root for two main characters that are deliberately going against what we've basically learned in all the previous Jurassic Park movies, especially the first one. So if they're going to at least do that, they should really get into that moral argument more in this film. You know, talk about why they have a moral obligation to go save these dinosaurs. But they don't really dive into that much. They're just kind of like, have to go do it because they're kind of like animal rights activists and they just want to save them because they're animals. Which is fine, but like, if you're going to go that route and go against the pretty much the bulk theme of Jurassic Park, I would have enjoyed it more if there was more of a philosophical debate or dissection of what they're trying to do here. But I mean, just to give the movie some credit, it does at least attempt a few times to try and get you to see things how they're seeing it. For instance, once they, you know, narrowly get off the island as the volcano's erupting, which, by the way, I didn't think was shot all that great, except when they fell in the water and the water started getting to the little bubble. I thought that was pretty cool, and that was shot decently. But yeah, as they're escaping the island, from far away, they see a brontosaurus that got left behind on the island as, like, the volcanic ash and the volcanic smoke is just, like, consuming everything. And they see, like, a glimpse of and also us as the audience sees a glimpse of the brontosaurus just kind of, you know, eventually getting consumed by the smoke and turning into like a shadowy silhouette. And, you know, I get that. That was an attempt to allow us to see where they're coming from. But to me, it just wasn't enough because, yeah, we get it. They're going to die and they're going to suffer. We knew that. You established that there's a volcano that's going to erupt. We get it. We knew that. But, you know, just to give it again some credit, at least it did that. And the film also tries to take a page out of Jurassic Park's book by trying to start the movie off with a kind of like ominous, I guess if you want to call it that. I think they were trying to go for that, but it didn't work. But just kind of like a thrilling sequence in the very beginning to kind of get to try to hook the audience. But God, it was just like done so poorly. It was just done in the most lazy, most Hollywood cheese way I've ever seen. I mean, it had two predictable Hollywood cheesy moments to where you knew what was going to happen next just because of the stupidity of the way it's written. Like, for instance, in the beginning, there's a guy that's trying to do something. I don't even remember. A T-Rex is about to get him, and all of his friends are just like, "There's a dinosaur behind you, dude! There's a dinosaur behind you!" What? What are you saying?
And on top of that, he jumps on top. He finally gets a grip on that long helicopter ladder rope thing that we see in tons of movies. And he also does that predictable thing where he celebrates way too early, and you know that that's like a foreshadowing moment that something bad's gonna happen. Like in one second later, he grabs on. And he's just like, "Yeah, I made it! I did it! Woo!" And then a giant, just fucking huge sea dinosaur just comes up and just kills him instantly. It's just like, why? Like, why? Why did you, like? I can understand trying to make that sequence happen and trying to make it thrilling. But why did it have to be directed so flat and written just so predictably and so cheesily? It's they just don't even care anymore. And that's, again, this is why I'm just upset. This is now that kind of movie. Like, now Jurassic Park is the franchise where it's just, do you want to see dinosaurs fuck shit up for a while? This is your movie. If you want anything more than that, it's just done. It's just, they don't care. They really don't care. All they want to do now is secure that money because they know that really, families and like casual families and kids to teenagers, they're not gonna care. They don't care. They all they want to do is go see a fun, action-packed movie that's got some humor woven through it, regardless if it's actually funny or not. They'll laugh at it because, you know, why not? And that's just what it's turned into. It's not what Jurassic Park used to be at all. And that's kind of upsetting because why have we moved that bar to this point? Like, we lowered the bar now for Jurassic Park, and it's just like, oh yeah, as long as there's dinosaurs. And as long as there's just a bunch of dinosaurs ripping shit up, that's fine. You know, who cares about likable characters? Who cares about character arcs? Who cares about, you know, thematic elements? Who cares about the aesthetics? Aesthetics, what the fuck's that?
And that really is another huge thing. There is no aesthetic immersion in this movie, at least for me. Like, there was maybe, like, out of its 2 hour and, I think it's 2 hours and 8 minutes, out of that entire runtime, I'd say I was really only immersed in about 5 minutes of it. 5 total minutes was I immersed into what was happening. And again, it's just there's no creative direction in its aesthetics or its approach in general. There really isn't. Like, all of it, the entire time I was watching this movie, I just felt like I was watching a movie. I wasn't wrapped up into the world at all. And it's called Jurassic World. Do you think that would really make you feel part of the world? But they don't. At least for me, I felt left out. And like I said, it's only maybe like 5 minutes of actual immersion. And most of that was just achieved just because there was a quick, like, 1 minute or 2 minute thrilling sequence. Like the one where they're trying to, like, steal T-Rex blood because they're trying to help out Blue, the raptor. You know, that scene where they kind of got stuck in that cargo trailer with the T-Rex, I thought that was, you know, I was actually immersed in that somewhat. So, again, that was done fine. But, you know, that's not enough for me. I need more than that. I need everything else that makes a good film to be in this movie, especially since the standard is Jurassic Park. That's the standard I'm always going to hold it to. And by the way, there's so many dinosaurs in this movie. There's a shitload. This probably tops the most dinosaurs I've seen in a Jurassic Park movie. There's so many different kinds of species they show in this movie. And, you know, not all of it looks amazing, but I think most of it's passable, as it should be. And you know, the violence in this movie, I thought was okay at times. I think the violence in this movie was actually more satisfying than the previous one. There's actually scenes in this movie that kind of go pretty far with the violence. I was surprised. I mean, it shows somebody's, you know, arm get ripped off at, like, in slow time, too. Like, it's not just it rips it off immediately. Like, you get to see somebody's arm pretty much slowly kind of get gnawed off, which was kind of cool to watch. Like, really, all I can give this movie is that some moments were cool to watch, and that's it. But really, other than that, it just kind of fell flat for me. A lot of it did. All of the attempts at obvious nostalgia didn't work for me at all. I mean, some of it was kind of cool, I guess, but it's like I'm trying to give this movie credit, more credit than it should get, because I just love Jurassic Park, but I just can't. Like, I can't. Like, all the nostalgia moments just seemed like, oh, look at this. Don't you like that? Because you watched it when you were a kid or when you were younger. And I'm just like, I don't want that. Like, you could take away all the nostalgia and just replace all the attempts at nostalgia with actual story writing, character writing, and aesthetics, and I will be way happier. It's just odd. I feel like they knew that this story writing and these character choices were not really good at all, at least in terms of relating it to the theme that we've learned. And they just decided, well, you know what? How about we just get Jeff Goldblum to be the voice of clarity in the beginning and in the end? And as long as there's somebody that understands that they're stupid, then maybe it'll be okay. And whatever, Jeff Goldblum's appearance in this movie is probably my favorite character appearance, because again, he seemed the only one to make any sense. And then after everything's all said and done, the ending, you know, conveys that these dinosaurs are now going to attempt to coexist with humans, and because basically they all got let wild, fucking little girl did it, but basically they're all let wild now, and now they're just roaming human habitats, and they're just gonna see how that goes. And at first I was like, how are they gonna coexist, or how are these dinosaurs even gonna reproduce, and how are these dinosaurs even gonna really survive, because a lot of them are just one species a piece. So how are they gonna thrive? And then I remembered the first Jurassic Park, and I was like,
that life finds a way.
Goddamn right. So overall, like I said, it's got some enjoyable moments in it that you're like, okay, like, that was fun to watch. But overall, I just think it's lacking in its theme, it's lacking in its story, it's lacking in its characters, it's lacking in its aesthetics, it's lacking in pretty much all phases of filmmaking that I would need to consider it to be a good movie. So overall, I'm going to give Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom a 4 out of 10. 2 points for Jeff Goldblum, and 2 more points for 2 scenes that I thought were done okay. But like I said already, here's my recommendation. If you just wanna, you know, take the kids, maybe between ages like 11 and up, and you just want to go, and you're just a casual moviegoer, and you just want to watch an action blockbuster with dinosaurs in it, just tearing shit apart, go watch it. You'll like it. I 100% guarantee you'll probably be satisfied with the price of admission. But for like actual Jurassic Park fans who really loved the first one, and if you didn't like Jurassic World, you ain't gonna like this one. So, you know, for all those people, I think for like film lovers, I don't think that y'all will get much from it. I don't really recommend seeing it. Maybe if it's on Netflix one day or something, to where it's nothing of your cost or time, then go. I mean, have at it, I guess. But I think you could probably still find 2 hours of better worth to do with your time. But all right, thank you so much for hearing what I had to say about Jurassic World: Fallen Kingdom. If you've already seen it and you liked it or disliked it, please let me know about it in the comment section below. And if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it amongst your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to the Misfit Pond channel to be updated on more film-related content.